Happy to join in the media center by Alena Sharp. Alena, how's it feel being back in Canada for your national championship?
Well, it's always a great week to come back to Canada, no matter where we are. I feel very welcomed from Ontario, but when we play in BC or Alberta or Quebec, I feel like I'm at home, so it's nice to be home.
Big week for Canadian golf with Brooke obviously winning in Portland and then getting membership. She said that you've been a really important aspect to her on tour. What have you done to kind of mentor her?
Well, we've gotten to become pretty good friends over the last year, and I've helped her a little bit with course management stuff, like giving her tips on some of the greens and some of the courses where she had to Monday qualify. Like in Texas, she didn't get to see the course, so I kind of gave her the layout. I'm sure my tips were wrong because the course was soft this year, but we've built a friendship that way. We play practice rounds together, and she's kind of pushed me to play better. And being around her, it's like, you know, I see how I was when I was 17. I didn't think as much, so I'm getting back into that. And I think everybody goes through that in their career where they come out fearless and then they get a little older and there's a lot of stuff going on, and then you want to be a kid again. And playing, being around Brooke has really brought that out in me, and she's made me play better, so it's a great friendship that we have.
How have you noticed her kind of grow up from her first event out here into now at being a full-time member?
Well, I think that she's very mature to begin with, and I think that just growing up as a player, maybe she just felt more confidence, had more experience being in contention to win, because she's been in contention so many times this year. It was nice to see her get it done in Portland, and all those other experiences probably helped her play very solidly on the weekend.
All right, we'll open up for questions. If anyone has one, please wake up for a mic.
Hey, Elena, an Olympic question, if I might. I believe right now you fall comfortably within the top 60. Just wondering about what that would mean to you. Is it front of mind right now? Just how exciting it would be, and also its benefit for women's golf.
Well, it's kind of in the back of my mind because it's still a year away. A lot of golf is still to be played. I could still get past, but I'm just trying to take it one week at a time out here, and if I do well, I'll keep moving up on the Rolex rankings. I had a big jump last week, and it means a lot to me to be able to play, because 4 years from now I'm going to be 38. There's a lot of young players coming up. I don't want to retire or get, you know, I want to keep playing and be competitive, but you just never know what's going to happen. So I have a really good shot to making the team, and would love to be there with Brooke, and I think we'd be a great duo out there in Rio. And I guess as the year goes on, it's more in the forefront of my mind. And then having the Olympics have golf, I think that's it's a great thing to be able to be a part of. And I'm sure that most of the LPGA players would say the same thing, that to represent your country is something that you always want to do.
Brooke's win obviously has brought some attention to Canadian women's golf. I mean, do you feel that we're sort of entering a new sort of era here, and there seems to be a lot of young Canadian women coming up? You look at the Symetra Tour week to week, and you see a lot of Canadian flags on that leaderboard. So are you pretty confident that you're going to have some more Canadian company on the LPGA Tour in the not too distant future?
Well, I really hope so. In the last couple of years ago, there was seven of us on tour, and not so many this year, but I think that Golf Canada is doing a great job in promoting junior golf and amateur golf, and they have a great coach and a great program for them, and I think it's really helping their games. And I'd love to see more Canadians out on tour. It's nice to see the Canadian flags up anywhere you look, and even the men's tour this year, the men have been playing well too, so it's nice that Canada's getting back on the map with golf.
Well, Alena, looking ahead to this week, what are your thoughts on the course in general, and how do you plan to attack it?
Well, it's actually, because we're in kind of the same situation as Portland, weather-wise, it's dry, it's same conditions, so maybe not as firm on the greens, but definitely playing for some run out. Want to be below most of the pins here, because being above it, it's very difficult to attack birdies. And some holes, not so much driver, but definitely use my length to my advantage and have wedges into these greens so I can actually stop the ball close to the pin.
And finally, you're on some good form lately, coming off that solid week in Portland. What would it mean to you to add another Canadian victory, but this time you?
Oh, it'd be, I mean, if this was Sunday night and we were doing a press conference, I'd be speechless. It would be amazing to do that, and it's only Wednesday, just take it one day at a time, and I would love to be on those last nine holes, have a chance to win.
Well, we appreciate the time. Best of luck this
week. Thank you.